Nick's playing RimWorld.
For literally the first time. So prepare to watch me die and fail horribly.
We could be doing Dwarf Fortress.
This is essentially Space Dwarf Fortress, so... Yeah.
Yeah, I hear. That's what I hear from is that it is Dwarf Fortress, a little easier than Dwarf Fortress, but kind of the same concept.
Also more understandable than Dwarf Fortress, though, because it has a UI that was made earlier than 1991.
Is it true that you can't use keyboard and mouse for Dwarf Fortress?
I remember being able to use my mouse, like, the one time I tried it. Anywho, I shall start a new colony. And since we are the Pentateuch of how... whatever Chase named this stream, I will go with the Lost Tribe start that gives me 5 people.
The Pentateuch of the Cosmogony. Was not to know about that, Nick. You took that astronomy class once. You should know what that means.
I suppose. Although, to be honest, the only reason I knew what cosmogony is because I took a religious studies class, not an astronomy class.
Shouldn't you know what Pentateuch is then from the same class, though?
No, because it was Egyptian religion.
Oh.
Yeah. So there's how I knew what the Pentateuch of the Cosmogony was. Okay, well. Lost Tribe, your tribe was destroyed by the great blood machine sent by the gods. 5 of you managed to escape. Now it's time to build a new home. Gotta love those great blood machines.
That sounds like a pretty badass metal band name. Hey guys, you want to start a metal band called Blood Machines?
Okay, do we have to do any actual instrument playing with it?
Probably. Hey, it's Tracer!
Indeed.
No? Okay. I forgot. Either of you know who.
I did say indeed.
Yeah, but
in fact know who Tracer is, because
yes,
I have
Yes, but
to...
usually when you say indeed, it's just like, yeah, sure. That's how I use it, at least.
Free play, base builder. Rough.
Rough the Destroyer.
Challenge. I'm gonna go with base builder. Yeah. That sounds like there might be a slight challenge, but I'm also not gonna just steamroll my way through the game. And let's not click that button right there, permadeath mode.
Is it possible to steamroll through this game?
Well, I mean, I suppose if you've played it several times. Anywho, we will be playing with Cassandra Classic, the classic storyteller, not Tracer, words, or that person.
The creepy guy biting a metal nail.
I think that's a cigarette.
Oh.
But yes.
Why does he have a smiley...
Looks like a cigarette to me.
You sound like a robot.
Yes, you do. Ooh. Let's see. Apparently, my world is Daria.
Daria Naharis?
Yes. Where to land?
Oh, by the way, Nick.
Sup?
You better play this game well, because this is literally what's going to sell the game for me.
No pressure.
No pressure or anything. It's just
Let's
a first
see.
Prep.
We got Extreme Desert. We got Ice Sheet. Nah. We got Temperate Forest. I'm just going to go Temperate Forest. I'm going to be gentle on myself this time because it's my first time playing.
Plus, if it's anything like Minecraft, you always start in a Temperate Forest.
Well, if I wanted, I could totally just start in an Extreme Desert. But I'm good. I like...
What's the difference between a desert and an Extreme Desert?
The Extreme Desert is more Sahara Desert than Sonora Desert.
Are you sure it's not just a bunch of people... jumping off of the dunes and buggies going, EXTREME!
Well, I mean, when the Burning Man festival comes.
Hey, don't be hating on Burning Man. That's where my uncle got married to a Canadian lady.
first of spring to the 11th of fall. I need to remember that. So I can actually, you know, grow food.
This is basically Stardew Valley.
Yes, except in space. And more complicated.
So Starbound. Which did just come out recently today, or recently off of Early Access.
My first character will be a childhood mad scientist adult war chief. Because, okay.
Good thing he's not a child war chief.
I'm going to re-randomize that.
What is all this?
Fire tender, healer, no. No. No.
What the hell?
Sure. These skills look good. Growing 9, that's lovely. Shooting 10. You don't need to be social.
Corey, could you mute your mic real quick? You can come back.
Okay.
Nick, I think you're getting a lot of feedback on yours. Could you try turning your sensitivity down just slightly?
Sure. Does that help? I moved it away. I'm not sure. I'd have to look in the settings to turn down sensitivity.
That made it worse.
That better?
Yes, much better, actually.
Cool.
Did you have a fan on?
Well, I do, but none of them are on me. They're just in the background. Okay. So that's probably what any background sound is fans, because I have 3 going in my room right now, because it's infernally hot in Bozeman right now.
Yeah, it really is.
Although not as bad as Immigrant.
How was that?
It was all right. I got to go eat at a nice restaurant.
Oh, real nice restaurant. I love that. That's the one thing I miss about being close.
You know what?
Nowhere.
This lady sounds fun. Cannibal, too smart, and ugly. Yes, I'm keeping you.
Yeah, you better keep her.
Neurotic and slothful. I'm good. Psychopath with bloodlust. Let's do that one. This is going to end horribly, but you know.
So, I found the story behind whatever the fuck we just named this stream.
Uh-huh.
The story and artwork within Pentateuch. One second. Okay, we're good?
Uh-huh.
It's about the discovery of an abandoned spacecraft in orbit around Jupiter. The book chronicles the project to decipher the ideograms in a Pentateuch document discovered within. The book is a retelling of this document in a similar way that modern-day translator might retell the contents of an ancient scroll. One of the amazing things is that ideographic script was created by Woodroffe and used throughout the artwork, a bit like Tolkien created the languages for Middle-earth. That is the story of this electronic album from 1979.
What?
Also, there's no lyrics, so...
Well, on that bombshell, let's start.
I was gonna say, on that bombshell, let's just end. 5 minutes in. But no, that's the meaning behind whatever the hell I named, is that it's a prog rock album from 79.
Of course it's a prog rock album from 1979.
Okay, the only reason it caught my eye is because of the amazing artwork. That's like from an 80s sci-fi epic. Mm-hmm.
By the way, can one of you check the stream for me?
I did, we're good.
Okay. If anybody has any questions, I've never played this game, but I'll do my best to answer them in chat. I won't answer. A Rimworld.
Lying chat.
Corey, your audio is terrible.
Yeah, Corey, what the hell is happening?
The gods were very angry. The blood machines came at night. They swept through your village, cutting and burning your people with their blades and devil fire. Only a few of you escaped. Now, after a harrowing journey on foot, with no close friends to turn to...
Wait, we need to redo this. Just with me doing this in the background.
You must build a new home in the wilderness, like your ancestors did. Hey, look, I have all kinds of...
things.
I have dogs. I have dogs.
So you're gonna eat the dogs?
Probably. Alright, so first off, this game has... tutorials aren't a thing this game really does, so...
Oh, yeah. The dog loves something.
The only reason I have any slight amount of clue of what I'm doing is because I've happened to watch, like, 5 episodes of this on Quill18's channel. Build, build, build. Where was build?
Oh god. This is how it's gonna be.
Says the person whose idea it was to do first impressions.
First impression. Well, that's because it would be cool. We can see, like, your progress. This looks shockingly like Prison Architect.
Yeah, it is very similar to Prison Architect look-wise, but that's fine, because I like the look of Prison Architect.
I didn't really. I'm not sure why, though. Like, I love the... First, I never really got much into Prison Architect. I just didn't like it too much. Yeah, for some reason, the art style of it... It was fine, of course, but...
Uh-huh.
It was just kind of odd.
So, fun side note. I totally spawned next to a Timberwolf. That's not going to end badly at all.
I was going to say you should probably kill it.
You should...
Damn.
Probably equip that. You should probably equip shortbow. You should probably equip Pila. Hey, Pila! That's a Roman weapon.
How do you know?
Well, I'm kind of a bit of a history major. Not to mention, I'm literally taking a class on Pompeii right now. Everybody, grab weapons! Everybody! Can't attack the Timberwolf. Okay, let's not do that. Work. Everybody should doctor. Everybody should do that one, from what I remember. And I'm just going to leave the rest as normal, because screw that noise. Oh, attack. Draft. Attack.
Are you playing Football Manager now? Draft. Draft. Attack Draft. The goalie.
I hit my own character.
Oh my god. There's okay. Music in this game, right?
Yes, it's. Okay. I can hear it. I just have it down.
Just on my end, it just set, everything sounds eerily quiet. I'm like,
so, the Timberwolf got handled. Although I totally managed to hit one of my own characters with a spear.
Oh my god.
So this is going well!
That is great.
Architect. Orders. Hey, I found the build options.
Oh joy. apologies for this cough that I have today.
Oh, stockpile zone. I should actually look around the map now real fast. See what I'm dealing with. Smaller map than I expect. Oh, never mind. Not a small... Ooh, hey, look, there's a building up here. That may come in handy. Eh. Those are mountains, so that's cool. You know, actually, this is not a terrible place to start building, so I'm actually going to use this area. Stockpile zone. Oh, gosh.
What?
No, I didn't. I didn't want to make my stockpile zone that big.
Nick, what are you doing? Are you destroying everything?
Stockpile zone. Kind of, not gonna lie.
Kind of what? Not gonna lie, what? What's happening?
I'm making a stockpile zone for my people to put things in.
Oh, okay.
I think.
Corey, do you have any idea what's going on here?
Corey?
We lost a man.
Well, see, I said, stockpile zone, I'm putting all my crap in a place.
We weren't far in, but...
Hey, I have a dog named Haskell, a dog named May, and a cat named Cheddar.
So, you rename the dog from Haskell to Rascal?
I don't think you can rename animals yet, if I remember right.
What?
You can rename people. Oh, Tona's gonna die. I should probably do something about that.
Okay, Corey's Still in chat. He just had to leave because his Skype's really bad right now.
Ah.
Okay. Well, that's not confusing at all. Two people.
Okay, so. Structure, wall, wood. Let's get a room to sleep in before things start going badly, like they inevitably will. You know, I think I'm gonna
things never go wrong in this.
I think I'm gonna be clever and just wall this area off.
Eh, probably for the best.
We'll put the door there, because why not?
I think someone just died outside my door.
I see. Well, what they do, I need to find steel, I just realized. Hey, it's a turkey! I found a turkey! Chase,
you can have Thanksgiving. What
is there a mugger breaking into your house?
I don't know what's happening.
Just out of curiosity.
I think I'm good for now. This is shockingly like prison.
It is very similar to prison architect, except about 15 times more complicated and varied. And there's an endgame state. So.
What do you mean endgame?
As in, well, not I'm not sure with this one because I'm doing the tribal start, but with the normal start, the story is you're a handful of colonists whose ship crashed, and the endgame goal is to rebuild your ship and leave the planet.
Oh, okay.
So that kind of defeats one of the problems of prison architect, where after a certain point, you're just like, whoa, well, there's a thing.
Yeah, I filled all my space.
What do I do now?
Make it better.
So steel would be a really nice thing to be able to find right now, but it's not going well.
Probably. So what was I going to ask? Oh, the narration at the beginning, since you had to choose. Is there, like, actual narration in the game, or how's that working right now?
Like, there's not vocal narration, but I think the way that it works is, depending on the story...
What's the point of choosing different ones, then?
Well, depending on the way the storyteller you pick, it'll change the way random encounters happen.
Oh, okay.
Like, Randy Random will just be like, I don't know, things happen.
Randy Random, that is a great name.
That was the weirdo smoking the cigarette and stuff.
We think he was smoking a cigarette.
Okay, hey, compacted steel. We should mine some of that, I feel like.
Probably not.
Why?
Because that seems like the right thing to do, and you shouldn't be doing the right thing.
Work. Work, work, work. Who do I have assigned to mining? Literally one person. Okay, well, you shouldn't haul then. Go mine.
So how do you get more people? Just
they just show up.
From what? You're in space.
Yes, but there's life on the planet. There's other settlements. See, factions.
Oh, okay.
There's small town at the cliff. Honesty's Cliff. Jeweler's Desert. Caxigo of Squirrel. And rifle group.
Caxigo of Squirrel.
Some of them are friendly and will trade with you. Some of them are hostile and will try and take you over or destroy you. Like I said, there's more things to do than in Prison Architect, essentially.
That was my major problem with Prison Architect, is that I was doing stuff and then I stopped. No. Yeah, it was just that, like, I had a small prison.
Uh-huh.
And then, yeah, I had a small prison. It was everything was going well, but then it's like, I don't want to bring more in because that'll ruin my ecosystem that I got going well. So I'm just going to not bring any more in, and then I was done.
Mm-hmm. Oh, structure. How do I designate that a room?
You put Tommy Wiseau in charge of it.
Oh, I need to put a roof over it.
Put a roof over their head. So they can sleep. Yay!
Fast forward! Dun 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 dun. Because once there's a roof over it, it's officially indoor space.
Corey has some great ideas in chat right now. You should take them, all the other settlements over, seduce their women, and indoctrinate their children.
This is RimWorld, not CK2.
I'm excited for CK2's new expansion, though.
Uh-huh.
Do they have a release date for that?
Not yet. That was just the announcement trailer, but probably within a month or two.
Okay. Because, yeah, I wasn't too interested in Conclave. Also, I have no money, so I didn't buy Conclave. But I might pick up the new one.
Uh-huh.
Mostly so I can have Plague Doctors.
Assign animals, factions. Like I said, this is, like, if you zoom in, for instance, there's this one little red dot right here, that's where there's another faction.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
How big are these maps, then? Pretty large?
Well, hold on, back to world map. That's me, right there.
Remember that I'm looking at a...
It'll zoom in just a second.
Is the world map in a separate window? Because I'm not seeing it at all.
You should be. I'm seeing it on my stream. It's just the map I pulled up.
Yeah, one second. I'll get there. You keep going and I'll see it eventually. I'm seeing it. What the hell? Okay. Oh, there it is.
I'm just attempting to remember how to designate a medical bed because I have people who are bleeding out and dying. I think they're healing in the sleeping spots I added, so we're good. Growing zone. I need one of those. Desperately. Yes, Chase?
Do you not have chat up?
What did they... I see it now.
Some good jokes.
No, they didn't trip on the tent. They fought a wolf, and one of them may or may not have gotten hit by a spear thrown by another one of them.
Well, that just isn't smart.
What are you people planting? Are those potatoes?
Are they Irish?
I think they're planting potatoes. I really hope they're planting potatoes. Work.
I apologize for the outside noise.
It's fine.
How much are you hearing of it?
Just off in the background. It's not annoying.
Okay.
I'll let Corey be the judge of that. I just stare at Chad until he answers.
Okay, yeah, they're planting potatoes. We're fine. Cool. Crisis averted. And we're mining steel, so we... Oh, we do actually have a door. Never mind, we're good. Well, still, it'll probably be handy to have some steel.
Are you sure?
Yeah, we have a door. Sure? See? Cheddar just went through it, and so did Haskell.
You gotta rename those.
Look, one of my settlers is named Pony, so... It could be worse. Oh, Chase, I...
What?
On my way up to Immigrant, I totally got lost in Livingston today.
How do you get lost in a tiny town?
Because I was going to take the second exit that exits by the gas station, and I took the first exit, and I need...
Oh my god.
And that's literally the second time I've taken that exit. The first time was when you were driving, so...
So for context, for everyone else, this town has literally two exits. That's it. Literally, you take that exit, you keep going until you hit the town, then
Pony.
You take a right.
Pony, what are you...
You just keep going. Literally, both exits come out on the exact same street.
So Pony's cloud watching.
Good for Pony.
What is everybody else up to? Banastra, you are... just healthy.
So,
what's up?
I just downloaded Dwarf Fortress.
Oh my.
How bad is it?
I have no clue.
I thought you played it once.
Well, it was terrifying, but I mean, I admittedly only played it for about 15 minutes before I just went... Before I just went, nope.
Watch me get it instantly. And then... Well, laugh at you because you're a pleb.
We'll just see about that.
Okay.
Oh, I should probably make it dumping area. Not that kind of dumping, and you know it.
Hey, this game actually has music. It went dun, dun, yay. What am I watching?
Right now?
Hmm?
What do you mean?
The Dwarf Fortress intro.
Oh. No, do allow rotten. Don't want chunks. I just want corpses in that pile.
I'm sorry, what?
Well, I need somewhere to dump the direwolf corpse so people don't get depressed that there's a direwolf corpse in the middle of camp. Because people will get depressed. Because, yes, that is a thing.
Oh my god.
You have to worry about people's mental states.
Are they all crazy?
Well, one of them is genuinely a psychopath, so yes.
Is this also the cannibal?
Possibly? I need...
Belgrade Police!
Hello.
Well, on that bombshell, folks. We're just gonna sit here and chill and build our little colony. Don't mind. And Corey can entertain you all in the chat. Corey, be entertaining. Because I'm busy... going, oh my gosh, I have no clue what I'm doing. Oh yeah, I forgot. I'm totally just, like... primitives. You do that, Corey. You do that. Ooh, I can build sandbags. That sounds fun. I should build some sandbags. I feel like those are facing the wrong way. Jeez, they need 3 steel each. Maybe I won't build sandbags.
So, I gotta go.
Alrighty.
Yeah, I need to go talk to the cops.
You do that, I'll be here.
Oh, I'm just kidding you.
Oh.
It was just my roommate.
I kind of figured that much.
He likes to just, like, barge in and just scream at me. Like, last time it was as a drill sergeant. Just came and was like, God, we can't be toilet. I'm like, fuck! I can't do exercise, there's no room in my room.
Holy crap, there's glowing snails. Boomalopes.
Boomalopes?
Boomalopes.
What the hell?
What?
Trying to figure out Dwarf Fortress.
Good luck.
I think it broke. Oh. Okay, it's back. I think. Oh, it has crashed.
This is going well for you. Huh.
It's not my fault.
I can build a sarcophagus.
Corey, I'm telling him everything. Telling him how... You stole something.
Fizzy lifting drinks.
You stole fizzy lifting drinks.
You lose, sir. You get nothing.
I was going to say he stole my heart, but...
But let's be honest, we all know he stole fizzy lifting drinks. Why is there a raccoon asleep in my field?
This game totally crashed on me. What a thrilling way to start this. Okay.
Oh, I should probably put animal sleeping spots. Oops.
You should probably do what?
Put in animal sleeping spots. There.
Probably.
Yo, Cheddar. Oops.
Sup, Cheddar?
Puppy!
Are you talking to your actual puppy there?
Yes. How do I... Okay, they're fine sleeping outside for tonight. That's no big deal. Miscellaneous sun lamp. Furniture. Torch lamp. Perfect. How much is a standing lamp? 15 steel, sure. I don't want to have to refuel it with wood. I have enough steel. Yeah, I have 325. I can afford a couple.
Then everything goes wrong.
Cool, well, let's just let them sleep for now. Unrestrict that so they can actually get rid of that dead dire wolf that's kind of just sitting in the middle of camp.
Wouldn't people be happy to see that? But be like, yeah, no wolf's going to mess with us.
Not when it starts rotting.
I guess. Use the world as it currently exists. Continue abort.
I need to handle something super duper fast. Just explain Dwarf Fortress for like 2 seconds.
Okay, so... I have no fucking clue what's going on. It's all a bunch of colored letters as a map, like land is N, ocean are little X's. It's all text-based. What? This game is came out in 2005 and they're running it on fucking DOS. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to figure this out, so I'm going to exit out. Did Nick leave it unpaused? So I'm just going to watch what Nick's characters get into. I'm not going to do that. Okay. I don't know what to do here since I'm not really running the game. Now I know how they felt. when I kind of bailed last stream. Was that last stream? 2 streams ago, yeah. Oh my god. But at least, okay, the difference is, yeah, thank you, Corey, it was Monday. The difference is, though, there were 2 people in the call still, so they could talk to each other. I only got myself and my mind, and I don't have a good mind.
Okay, sorry about that.
Hello.
Hello. What did I miss?
Nothing.
Other than...
I judged you for having the game on pause while you left.
Yeah, I did miss something. Apparently 2 of my people got wounded while I was gone.
What'd you have to do?
My mom wanted to show me something super fast. In the kitchen.
Was it food?
Is elk beating my other people up?
Elk?
Because it looks like... Oh my gosh. Elk. Elk. Lady. Lady.
Okay, is it
Is
elk
that her
here?
Definition of nice chat with Trobone?
You good there?
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now I can.
I think I was sitting on the button that turns off my mic. Anyway. So... Apparently, there must have been a raid while I was gone or something, because... Yeah.
There's also a rave happening
But
somewhere.
They're healing, so at least there's that. Oh, these need power. Well, that was a complete waste then, because I have no way to do that, so deconstruct those.
I think you're doing this game wrong.
Probably. Not going to deny that.
I just want Quill to come into the chat and just tell you everything that's wrong right now.
Could be worse. I could be you doing Dwarf Fortress.
Yeah, I gave up already.
I told you.
Well, it doesn't help that it's literally, like, it's just text. They just colored it differently.
Uh-huh. So I'm going to set some priorities while I do this.
Like, when voting?
No, like, what work to do first.
Oh.
Because you can do that.
Probably build a door first.
I built a door.
I have no ideas then.
No, as in, like, say if they're wounded, go rest before doing anything else. This game has a very Firefly-y soundtrack, and I like it. Firefly is purportedly one of the two major inspirations for this game.
Was it Firefly and Dwarf Fortress?
Yep, the other is Dwarf Fortress.
Like, you should throw Prison Architect in there, too, just because it has the same art style.
Yeah.
I do like, though, that the devs actually got in touch with the people from Prison Architect. It was just like, yo, do you mind if we use the same art style? And they're like, well, I don't care. Let's make it a different game.
One. You can stay at three. Is that... Okay, yeah. Well, since... There. That'll do. Hallcraft. 2. 6. Ooh, never mind. 3. What's your skill? 7. Well, you can be our official crafter. I have an official crafter! 1.
Oh, joyous day.
2. 3. Okay. Sure, we'll call that good, because I totally know what I'm doing.
This is painful to watch, since I know what you need to do.
What do I need to do?
I'm not telling you.
Build a door?
Yes!
Chase, what is this right here that everybody is going through?
Mine steel, Nick!
I did.
Oh. mine... iron?
There is no iron, just steel.
There is no iron, only steel.
Oh, so people are eating all my food. I should probably get somebody on hunting.
Yeah, Nick. Build a window.
Who's my best hunter?
Probably me, because, well, I've actually been hunting. And it's my middle name.
Tona Loner Banastra, you hunt.
That guy's name isn't Chase. You betraying me, Nick?
No. Go kill us a turkey. Actually, don't, because those are tameable. Kill the deer.
Kill the deer. Slit its throat. Spill its blood.
Because I need food, so... Because I just saw our last meal being eaten.
No, you just need a really nice trophy on the wall. That's why I'd kill the deer, at least.
Ah.
No, that's... I hate people who do that. Hunt for meat, not for sport.
Well, I am, so...
I respect you as an individual.
Woo! But no, I'm liking this game.
That's good. I'm not sure if... I don't think I'll pick it up anytime soon.
That's fine. I mean, to
it
be
doesn't
fair...
doesn't have multiplayer, does it?
I don't think so. I mean, it's only in, like, Alpha 14 right now.
Oh, screw that, then.
Just saying, for a game in Alpha, this looks pretty nice. But no, I'm much more a management game player than you are, so...
True. But I bet I could rock your ass at Roller Coaster Tycoon.
Probably. Well...
Wait. Isn't Stardew Valley a management game?
Stardew Valley is like a weird, like, management RPG.
I guess. Yeah. So I got married in Stardew Valley. I told you this story, but I'm gonna repeat it just for the sake of it's funny. So, especially since the person that almost screwed me over is the one Corey was going after. So he got married. Plus he didn't. Corey, try getting back in Skype again. Let's just see if it works better.
Hello?
Hello!
Keep talking.
Do I sound like a robot?
Much better.
Okay.
So, I was playing Stardew Valley. Welcome back, by the way. And I got married to Leia. Finally. It was a good day. I proposed to her in a bar. Just like my dad did. You know?
But
proposed to Leia or proposed to your mom?
Probably, I wouldn't doubt it, actually, if it was my actual parents did that. But, so, I get back from the wedding, and there's a message in my mailbox. Fuck me, that was annoying. There's a message in my mailbox, and it's from Penny, Corey, to meet her in the bathhouse that night, the night of my wedding.
To do that thing with the screenshot I sent you?
Yes, I assume so. So I had to go to the bathhouse at night, risking cheating on my wife because I didn't know if it was going to, like, let me choose. Literally the night of my marriage, Penny sends me, was like, yo, you should meet me at the bathhouse. Like, she's such a sweet girl. And now she's like, I'm going to stab that bitch right in the back on the night of her wedding. I was able to turn her down, though, and she cried and ran away.
Oh.
That's literally what happened. She was like, are you serious? Wah! And then just, like, sprints out of the bathhouse. I'm like, dodge that bullet.
Wait, but you never gave her a bouquet.
Yeah, I did. You can give multiple people bouquets to get the 10 heart statuses.
Wait, so you're just trying to get to the 10 heart status for everyone.
I was, but now that I'm married, you can't. Like, if you... You can give as many people as you want bouquets, but you just can't marry any of them. Well, you can only marry one of them. And then after that, you can't give any more bouquets because, well, that's cheating.
Well, then again, you're more focused on the social links than I am.
Yeah. Anyway, Nick, what's going on here? Let's not turn this into a Stardew Valley stream again.
I am attempting to set up my kitchen, essentially. There we go. Also, it's raining, because I noticed that the Ibex that was totally supposed to be... Oh, somebody just ate the rotten direwolf corpse. Okay. Yeah. I'm working on it.
You need to get these people into line, Nick.
To be fair, it was the crazy person.
So? That lowers
morale.
Who's
in a poor mood? Elk. Why are you in a poor mood?
Who's Elk? Wait, is Elk the name of someone, or is it an elk, like,
no, it's the nickname of someone. It is Elk.
Oh! That makes so much more sense.
Slept in the cold, slept on the ground, insulted, shared a bedroom, in a little pain, disturbed sleep times 4, ate without table. Well, maybe if you hadn't eaten 3 corpses, you wouldn't be in a bad mood. So, don't be surprised if this run ends miserably, just saying.
What's the backup plan if this just, like, lights itself on fire?
I can always just start a new run.
I guess.
Or I can go play Prison Architect that I'm competent at.
Or CK2.
True.
What were you doing today in the game?
Just playing a little on my Rome save.
Okay.
I got, like, 6 years down. Most of it was just in, like... petty little civil wars because people were civil warring their kings/queens when they died, and then the king/queen would die, so I'd have to deal with the war. It was kind of annoying. Ibex. Who's my cook? Cook. Cook, you are Pony. Pony is my cook. Pony!
That is an awful idea. You don't let horses cook, Nick. Just like you never let horses vote.
But sometimes you have to put the horse on the Senate.
No, they'll just wish for a stable economy.
It could be worse. You can make literally any other political joke right now.
True. Hey, Nick, did you get that screenshot I sent you?
Possibly.
Okay, it's not a screenshot, but... I would send it to Corey. Oh, wait, the link. The link I put in chat, Corey, did you click it?
I avoid clicking links you put at you.
What? Nick, would Corey approve of the link?
Is it the link I'm thinking it is?
The one that I sent you in chat, yeah.
Oh, it's PBS. Maybe I will.
You people just don't trust me anymore.
I feel like this is a link I haven't actually seen.
Well,
yeah, that's not a PBS link. That's a Twitter link.
Yeah. You don't tell him that, Nick.
Oh my gosh. That was an entertaining moment. Somebody's in a terrible mood. Elk, stop eating bodies and maybe you won't be in a terrible mood.
Why
just
would
saying.
Elk eat bodies? Elk are herbivores.
Hey, look, I put torches up. I have light now.
Good for you.
People aren't literally just sleeping in a cave.
Well, it's still a cave, just there's light in it now.
Technically speaking, it's not a cave. It's just an open space I put a roof over.
I'm sorry, it's a tunnel. It's a cavernous labyrinth. What do you want from me, Nick?
Your support.
Table.
I'll never support Nick.
Bills. Add Bill.
Butcher but he was going to make you VP.
I'll support Nick. He'd be the one running the country, and I'd be the one burning it to the ground.
Wait, then shouldn't you be running for president?
Seriously, Nick, you have to admit, if you and I, like, were... You were president and I was vice president, it would pretty much be you trying to fix my mistakes.
Uh-huh.
Just the entire time.
Oh, good. People are starving. Yeah, I think I figured out how to use the kitchen, though.
Now can you, The Sims it?
Yay, look, I'm slaughtering the ibex.
There's ibex in this game, but not proper elk.
Yay, people
Wait,
have
hold
food.
Up, better question. There's ibex on an alien world.
Yes. But there are also boomalopes, so...
Well, it's weird original Star Trek rules.
I don't know what that means.
Everyone looks human because we have shared DNA because of reasons.
Technically, it's more Firefly universe than Star Trek universe. This is just on the edge. This is a planet on the periphery of human space, essentially.
Are you saying that it's on a Rimworld?
Yes.
Bum bum
dun,
bum
bum.
I should probably build people beds.
Well, they can sleep on the rocks. It's good for their backs.
I disagree. When we went camping, I slept on rocks, and it wasn't fun.
I think we all had a rock to sleep on.
You people had, like, blow-up mattresses and blankets. I had nothing.
Mine was brand new, and I didn't unravel it until I was going to sleep.
I do enjoy that most of these streams just consist of stories from our one camping trip that we've ever had.
Yeah, we seriously need to do another camping trip so we have more stories.
Yes. I'm going camping this Sunday, but I don't think you guys will want to be with the company that I'm going with.
I don't know. I mean, Nick did survive a camping trip with Sage.
I'm planning bedrooms for my folks now.
Did you feel sorry for them after we've been talking about sleeping on rocks?
Yes.
I mean, if you have the resources, why not?
I have a lady who can mine. That's essentially the resources I need.
Don't you need cloth for beds?
No, I mean, yeah, that's not... I'm not talking to beds. I'm mining out a bedroom, right? A bedroom space right now.
Don't you need 3 metal and 3 cloth for beds?
It's 3 wood. Come on, get it right.
Hey, handy steel. I found more steel.
What's the difference between steel and handy steel?
On a good note, people aren't dying anymore. Hey, people!
Wait, did someone die?
No.
Oh.
They want to trade? Do you want to trade? Who's my warden? Elk.
Instead of Elk is your warden. Does Elk just do everything?
No, that she's just my warden and my hunter, apparently. Where are you, Elk? There you are. Elk. Can trade with Dodson, yes.
Oh, this is much better. Since I can't hear the game audio at all, and it's eerily quiet, I just put on... Oh, fuck. Pentakook of Cosmetology. Just very low in the background. It's really fitting.
Okay. Yes, buy me the pemmican, because why not?
You're buying a pelican?
Pemmican. Food. I need food.
Oh. Pemmican. What's pemmican?
It's a type of food that I believe Native Americans made.
How do you spell it?
P-E-M-M-I-C-A-N.
Pemmican. Pemmican is a concentrated mixture of fat and protein used as a nutritious food. The word comes from the Cree word pemmican, which itself is derived from the word pimi, fat or grease. It was invented by the native people of North America. Good job, Nick. You're right on the button.
Yay.
How'd you know that?
Because I'm a history major.
So?
And I live in Montana.
So I don't know jack shit about Native Americans.
Well, you're not a history major.
Yes, but I live in Montana. Didn't you guys hate it in, like, I guess this won't apply to Nick, but, like, in 7th grade, we had this history teacher, and she was a grumpy old lady. But it was one of the reasons she was grumpy is because usually we spend, like, a quarter on Native American history and then three quarters on world history. But for some reason, the curriculum was changed under her nose. She was forced to do three quarters of Native American history, which was so boring. Mostly because we've heard it all before. We're in Montana. And then one quarter for her to get through all of ancient Rome and ancient Greece. And, like, Mesopotamia.
Huh.
So that's probably why I don't know much of my history.
Yeah, that wasn't the problem for me.
Because all they focused on was, like, the Chippewa, Cree, and Blackfeet. I'm like,
because
yes,
I just learned all that crap in Montana history.
I didn't have Montana history. It was bad.
That was just my 9th grade history class, just Montana history.
Actually, you guys are pretty much the exact opposite, then. Because my first 3 years of high school was world history, then U.S. history, and then U.S. government.
Huh.
We really didn't talk about Native Americans much at all.
I mean, I'd prefer that because I find world history much more interesting. Even American history to some extent of, like, the actual nation of America, not the continent itself.
I'm going out to hunt a boogaloo with a club. This can only end well.
Soon we'll be have...
Oh, a lot sorry. Of the more interesting stuff is about nations and what nations are doing.
Yeah, not just what this little tribe of Indians is doing.
What should my colony be named?
Greenslade.
Any vote from Corey?
Orion Slave.
I said Green Slade, not Slave.
Chase wins.
Yeah, buddy.
But. Well, did you expect me to actually name something?
Good point. Yeah. So history classes were kind of boring, is what we learned here.
I disagree, but... You know,
some of them.
I'm biased.
It depends on teachers, really. Plus, that 7th grade history teacher that I was telling you about was also... I met her later down the line, and she was like, yo, I can sense you're sick. I know some guy in Helena who can cure you. with aura and quantum physics. And I'm sitting there like... What the fuck are you on about, lady?
So...
You taught my class? What?
Remember that whole hunting of the boomalope with a club that I said I was going to do and how I said it wouldn't end badly?
It did end badly?
Yes.
What happened?
apparently my guy got injured and the boomalope got injured. You know what? Just go kill another ibex.
Oh, give your ibex.
Fine, I'll kill a raccoon. Hunt me a raccoon, hunt me...
an ibex.
Elk, what are you doing? You're relaxing socially with nobody. Who's my other hunter? Benastra, where is Benastra? Benastra, the heck are you doing? Oh, you're going to go hunt the boomalope.
How many people do you need to stick on this boomalope?
Apparently two. But this one's ranged, so this should go a lot better. Assuming she hits it. Assuming she hits it.
She's not gonna hit it. I can tell how this game goes now, and she's not.
Oh gosh, Bobcat. Oh my gosh. You'll see what just happened in just a second. I figured out why they're called boomalopes.
Did they just blow up?
I don't recommend going in there, Benastra. No.
Move her out.
Okay, she's out. Yeah, see? It's on stream for me. Is it on stream for you yet?
No. I haven't been paying attention much. Because remember that I've been missing the map, too.
Elk, the heck you doing? Cheddar, training. Trainable intelligence, none. Well, then what are you good for, elk? Wardening. Okay, fair enough. So, people are starving a lot, but, yeah.
Sounds like it's going pretty well.
As well as my first playthrough was probably going to go, honestly.
Wait, this is your first time playing?
Yes.
God, you suck. You know, I'm just kidding.
Speed up. See if we can't do something about this whole starvation issue.
Have you tried sacrificing one of your members for food?
I'd rather not, if I don't have to. Elk, are you just eating that corpse? Yes, of course you are. You glutton. Okay, well at least you're not starving, so I guess that's good. The dog is eating the corpse. Okay, people are just eating corpses because apparently they don't understand that.
It all started.
Okay, you know. Oh, now you take the corpse in to get slaughtered. Now that people have chewed on it.
It's all going so downhill.
Local raccoon has gone mad. It will attack everyone it sees.
Oh no, a raccoon. The fuck was that?
A raccoon, apparently.
That's what a raccoon sounds like?
No, that was from, like, Corey's mic. I'm just saying.
Corey, what just happened?
Someone went offline.
Oh.
That's your offline sound? So all my people are stuck inside my building because there's a mad raccoon trying to break down the door.
Oh. I have no words.
You know what?
There's
Benastra, it's I'm drafting you to kill the mad raccoon. Crap, you can't hit the target. Pony. I'm drafting you.
You're drafting a raccoon?
Melee attack the mad raccoon. Charge!
This is gonna go well.
Tona, I'm drafting you. Melee attack the raccoon. Melee attack. Everybody melee beat the raccoon to death.
Oh my god.
Okay. This fucking game.
You just declared war on a raccoon.
Just an army of raccoons just come in. Fuck!
On a good note, the raccoon is dead.
Oh. Well, that's good.
On another good note, nobody's starving anymore. So we're still alive.
I'm not even angry.
You're being so sincere right now.
I'm being so sincere right now. Even
I feel like it'd probably be a good idea to have more than one person be able to mine.
Don't you have like a child that you can go send in the mines?
Elk, you really don't have much else to do there, so... Oh, two.
What are you talking about? You gave Elk all the jobs.
No, just like the two jobs that I didn't have anybody doing. There we go. Now we have like four people mining.
So is it possible to build actual buildings and whatnot, or is
yes,
it just kind of cave
but I
dwellings?
I started with a prehistoric setting, essentially, so that's why they're all tribal people with bows and arrows.
Oh yeah, you started tribal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Does anyone remember the game Evil Genius?
Yes, I have Evil Genius.
You played Evil Genius. How great was that game?
It's an amazing game.
I never was able to play it properly, but...
You can get it off of Good Old Games.
I might.
I should have it actually be on Steam, too.
I'll look this up. Corey, did you ever play Evil Genius?
No, I did not.
I'd recommend it. I think you'd like it. Definitely, this is just reminding me of it because it was especially the building into the cave. Because that's where you build your evil lair and evil geniuses. It's like in this mountain where you like have a bunch of rooms for all your minions and whatnot. It's very Prison Architect-esque, except released over 10 years before Prison Architect.
Uh-huh.
I should pick that up at some point. I missed that game. Maybe I could actually play it properly now that I'm not a dumb child in elementary school picking on other children. Because that's what I did in elementary school. I was just the bully.
And now you're... Now you're a nerd.
That's what happens. You beat some kids up, then you realize, oh shit, they're playing video games. Video games are fun. I'm still gonna beat them up, because why not? I mean...
I don't think we would have been friends when we were younger.
Look, clearly I remember the boy. He was a harmless little fuck, really.
Do you remember that boy?
No, fuck off. He's a harmless little fuck, but
thank
then...
you, Chase.
But then I realized we unleashed a lion, and he bit the... He actually bit the recess aide's arm. Then he hit me with a surprise left, and it left my jaw hurting.
Why do I feel like you're just quoting a Prog song now?
You are wrong, Nick! Wanna know why?
Why?
Cause Jeremy spoke in class today. So yeah, you're wrong cause it's actually grunge, not Prog.
Tona, the heck you doing? You're cleaning dirt. Why are you cleaning dirt? Go to bed. Why are you mining? Everybody else is asleep.
He's just really into the art of Doro Dango.
Evil Genius is on sale right now on Good Old Games.
Oh, for how much?
$3.33.
Holy shit.
Do it.
Well, I know what I'm doing next stream. What?
It does look rather interesting.
Just the timing of it all. Sorry, the timing of it all. Because apparently... What the hell?
What?
I just opened my good old games account and there's like 20 games that I own.
Huh.
Is it the ones that...
I bought 4 of these. Alright. I'll accept them.
Well, I'm very happy Beneath a Steel Sky is free on good old games.
Oh yeah, what is that?
Classic adventure game.
Go on.
Sort of that kind of dystopian future sci-fi kind of thing. And you have a little robot that follows you around.
Oh. Is his name BB-8?
I'm pretty sure if the game was made today, there would be a BB-8-shaped thing you can put a processor into.
Somebody should... Okay, somebody does have Otona...
Daytona? Yeah, I think Ohio has Daytona. Or is that Florida? Where's Daytona?
Ohio.
Ha! I knew it!
Or is that Dayton?
Dayton's in Ohio. I know, because...
Daytona isn't in Ohio, because Daytona has a beach.
I'm gonna look it up.
It's in, like, Florida.
Daytona is... Florida, yeah. But Dayton is in Ohio. I know that because, well, I've been there. That's where my grandparents lived.
Indeed.
Fuck you, Nick. One of them's dead now.
I'm sorry?
Take interest, damn it.
You know, Banastra, you sleep all the way over here so you can have your own bed.
Ooh, this is a big decision for me. Should I get Evil Genius or the Stardew Valley soundtrack?
I mean, if you ask me, I'd rather have the game than the soundtrack.
Yeah, you're kind of right. Plus, it's on sale, so it's not going to be this price forever. I heard that.
I burped, I'm sorry.
I thought we didn't have a burping in the mic rule on this channel. Not like I enforce any of the rules anyways.
I mean, we're doing pretty good on the whole no political jokes joke. Unless they're really dumb like the horse one.
Or, okay, that ban is in effect until at least December, then we can bring it back up.
Oh, yeah, totally. Just after the election year.
All I know is we're going to have to listen to someone complaining for the next 8 years. And I don't really care who it is at this point.
It's going to be me. The one who just doesn't give a fuck. I mean, we all know that Rand Paul's got this in the bag.
Yes.
Yeah, fuck it.
Do it.
I did it. Something went wrong. Well, never mind.
Just do it again. Just do it.
Nick, what do you want me to do?
It! Where was those defenses? Security. Sandbags.
Are you sandbagging now? So how's your day, Corey?
My day was Persona 3.
Great! Moving on, because I really don't want to annoy Nick. I mean, if he wants us to.
Ooh. The potatoes aren't ready yet.
Okay, what part are you at? Then we're moving on. I swear, I promise, Nick.
just beat the September full moon.
I don't remember which one that is.
It was the one where we, where Chidori captures Junpei.
Spoilers.
Because he's an idiot.
Okay, I know what you're at.
There, I built defenses. I'm also building a storage room. So I can actually put my crap somewhere that isn't outside.
Never know when that mad raccoon might come back.
That mad raccoon is dead.
His family will come and avenge him.
Avengers assemble! Rocket Raccoon, go!
I knew we weren't going to get past that without with the Guardians of the Galaxy reference.
At least Guardians of the Galaxy is actually a non-shit Marvel movie. Because It actually does something different.
But that's just the trend right now. If we were in the era of Westerns, you'd be saying the same thing about those.
Well, maybe... Well, Westerns still can have different stories.
True.
Instead of... Ooh, there's a guy. Ooh, I'm gonna fight him.
I can build a table.
Ooh, he's threatening me or my loved ones. Okay, we're done. We won.
Build that
table. Like, seriously, how many different origin stories can you have? That's all I'm saying.
Maybe if they were... origin stories are probably the most unique parts of those movies.
Well, yes, but... We've already heard every origin story that they have for superheroes, because they're not inventing new superheroes anymore. They're just riding off the coattails of the superheroes that were made 40 fucking years ago.
Well, would you want to be the one to try to make a new superhero nowadays?
No. Because I'm not creative.
I mean, I made Super Duck when I was a freshman in high school.
I made Bug Boy when I was in 5th grade. He was the boy with the power of bugs. Shower me with money!
When I was in 4th grade, I made an even more shit version of Green Lantern.
That's possible.
Was Ryan Reynolds who you were thinking of casting?
No. Imagine someone with less acting ability.
Me.
No, because you would actually try to make it funny.
True. I actually used to write a lot of books when I was a little kid.
So my little settlement's coming along nicely.
Looks like it.
Except I mean, I have low
those
food,
three rooms
low
still
medicine.
Have a lot of rock in them.
Yeah, we're working on that. Hold on. Who all's idle?
Eric idle.
Everyone should be able to haul. Just saying.
Billy idle. That's all the idols I know. But no, here's my process of writing books when I was a little kid. Write the table of contents, have an awesome idea, and then scrap it. Because I only liked writing table of contents for some reason.
Well, I think at that point you formulated the entire book and you know the ending, and then you're just like, I'm not interested in this, I already know the ending.
I didn't know that's how you're supposed to write books. I thought you had supposed to have like the whole thing planned out and then start writing.
No, that's so far what I've heard is like, that's not a great thing to do.
Well, no one told third grade me that.
Well, no one told me that either.
Bastards! Nick, why did you tell us this?
It's not my fault, man.
Why did... What?
I didn't do it.
What's with the Jamaican accents?
I don't know.
Yes, it is. Nick, you're...
You're against the accent.
You're the author of all our pain.
There's their next band name, Author of Pain.
I figured out why those rocks weren't being moved, because I needed to order them to haul them. Oops. Okay, now they're moving out the rocks. Now we're good.
I'm on the edge of my seat.
You should be.
Whoa!
This bass is really coming along.
I know, it's getting kind of nice.
It's all right.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you're on your way. I mean, get a few flat screens, maybe a nice squishy couch,
a DVR so you can record all your shows even though you're not home. Apparently, Nick doesn't like that idea.
Ooh, research, information.
Ooh, show me the tech tree.
DVR joke, but then I was just like.
I'm not entirely sure. Oh, research. Here we go. Stone
now, why
cutting
are the torches
brewings.
In the main room brighter than the torches in the
I have
bedrooms?
No clue.
I think it's just because there's more of them. Plus, you have those furnaces going by. Oh, wait, those are beds. Never mind.
So, you just have to put beds in them and they'll get brighter?
I mean... Never mind. I'm not going to make that joke.
Electricity! Research that.
Oh, boy. No, you're good. I just about said something I was going to regret.
Behave yourself. Who the heck is this dude?
It's Elk.
What a... When did I get a new villager? Well, I have a new villager. Blue, what are your skills, man? Blue has a pistol. Oh, boy. You're a farmer.
You're right, I am. Who are you?
Okay. You'll both be farmers then. Plant cut.
This game also kind of reminds me of Banished.
Mm-hmm.
Anyone played that? Either of you played that?
I have Banished.
Oh, okay. I liked that game.
So yeah, good news. We got a new guy. Although he's disturbing everybody else who's trying to sleep right now by running past them and hauling rocks out of the building.
Is that actually a thing?
Yes. People get irritated if their sleep is disturbed.
That is great.
Well, they're going to have all new bedrooms once he's done, so, you know.
Nick, it says here on Steam that you do not, in fact, own Banished.
I have it on Good Old Games.
Oh, okay.
So
he bought it without supporting Valve and their not making Half-Life 3-ness.
How dare you? Gaben is life.
Elk is going to be very... I should probably get more food now that I think about it.
I don't know, I'm pretty sure Half-Life 3 is just going to be VR.
I just don't care because I never played any of the Half-Life games.
What to hunt?
I like the Half-Life games. I just don't really get the hype for another one. Like, still being hyped for another one.
Ooh, muffalos.
Because right now it seems more like people are just, where's Half-Life 3, rather than, what story element could Half-Life 3 build upon?
Yeah, anymore it's just, it's a meme. A very stupid meme.
Hmm.
Aren't most...
Should I hunt the Muffalo?
What?
The Muffalo, look at them. They're on screen right now. At least for me.
That name! That fucking name!
I know.
Okay.
I didn't name it.
Yeah, but that's still like... Isn't that like a common term?
Yes.
Then they should have seen that.
Yeah, this one... I'm not going to store food here.
Okay.
Doe, deer. Yeah, we'll kill that one.
Deer.
There's three males, two females, so there. Now they can all have nice monogamous relationships.
Monogamy!
No more deer orgies.
Is a sin.
Blue has a pistol.
Who has a pistol?
Blue.
Blue. Who's blue?
The new guy. Oh my gosh, the deers are angry.
Deers?
The deer are angry. You'll there see you in go. A minute.
Deers are angry. Good job. So here's my question. How the fuck do you stream Pokemon Go? Because apparently that's trending on Twitch.
I don't know. People know how to do it, and I don't. And, do you really want to stream Pokemon Go?
I don't. I'm just saying.
No, he wants you to stream Pokemon Go so he can judge you the
entire
stream.
No, Pokemon Go would be my walks.
So I caused a deer stampede.
Oh my god, Nick. Also, how the fuck is Persona 3 in the top 20 games being streamed right now?
Holy shit, we're playing the wrong game.
We know it's trending, guys. Sorry, Nick.
I would totally be playing Persona 3 right now if we could stream it.
We gotta hop on that trending list.
Everyone, go attack these stampeding deer before Blue dies. No, Blue's very, very wounded.
We don't like Blue. He's an asshole.
I prefer yellow.
I mean, we all know Pokemon Yellow was superior.
Were they?
So, oh my
well,
god.
Yeah, Yellow was like the third game they released after Red and Blue.
I'm sorry, what were you saying? I completely zoned out there.
I got a problem.
I'm sorry.
My colonist needs rescuing because he was killed by four deer.
That takes effort.
I am watching that now. That is actually hilarious.
That fucking takes effort. Holy shit.
These are very angry deer. I did not think this was going to be a bad idea, but apparently it was.
How do you do that?
Total ineptness?
Fight the deer! Is my colony going to be destroyed by deer?
Oh my god.
The raccoon was just a ruse. Direct real enemy.
The raccoon was just the start.
Bro! That was the worst Inception noise ever. I am terribly sorry.
Okay, so
never
this
be forgiven.
Is not going the greatest right now. Why are deer so mean?
How are you?
How am I losing to the deer? Banastra, no, we rescue Trobo. Go.
So, four deer versus five humans.
Six
humans with tools.
I don't know.
You do realize with just Chase and I, we could probably massacre a whole herd, right?
Yeah, well, you know what? Stop judging me.
I'm not judging you. I'm judging the idiots you're in charge of.
Deer, go away.
Sorry, I'm back.
Well, my colony's about to die to freaking deer, so...
Oh my god, Nick.
I can't help it! Well,
this is
there
what
we
I
go.
Missed. Was just... Did everyone get killed by deer?
Yep.
What?! Oh god. How?!
Because deer are apparently way meaner than I expected. Oh, but the dog.
Happen?
The dog took down a deer. Okay.
Boomer will live.
Well, on that bombshell, I suppose I need to start a new colony.
I think we just end it there. We can't stop your entire thing getting
actually, hold
by
on.
Fucking deer.
Let me see if I can load. Let me see where
You were murdered by Bambi!
I was murdered by Bambi's dad, to be fair.
Oh my. Bambi grew up, didn't he?
Yeah.
Well, there we go.
Note to self.
Oh, I just saw it on stream. Yeah.
There's so much blood. What the fuck happened? Deer are gentle. They're timid. They run away from you stepping on a branch.
Note to self. Deer are mean.
No, they're not.
They apparently don't like being shot at with a pistol.
They'll run away if that happens.
Blue, you are not allowed to attack deer. Just saying.
Going back to that Persona stream I was just watching.
But don't abandon us.
I might go join him.
But we have six Wait, people
will
watching
it have
right
spoilers?
Now.
No, I'm not. I'm not gonna leave. Okay. Actually, that is a great idea, because I was just watching it, and it's at a very spoilerific part of the game. So, yeah, don't look at that stream, Corey.
So, we're not going to hunt deer this time around.
That's probably a good idea.
That's apparently just suicide.
Oh, my God.
We're going to hunt a raccoon instead.
The raccoon will still try to murder you somehow.
Wow, Blue is inept at hunting.
This game, I know what this game is. It's After Earth without the shitty acting.
Blue, what is your hunting skill, buddy?
Everything on this world was designed to kill humans. Little deer pops up. No! I can't believe you, Nick.
It is kind of sad, but... Yeah. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie.
One of the few times I can say I've been in that exact situation you were in a video game... And I got through it much better in real life.
Let me guess, you just said live and let live, and the deer was just like, nature's a bitch, man. And then walked away?
No. I went up to a herd of deer, I shot one, and all the others ran away, and I never saw them again.
So on a good note, our potatoes are almost grown.
Fucking Irishman.
Well, now I figured out why the Irish were just such a
because the deer on Ireland tried to kill them.
Not a deer, so they didn't rely on anything other than potatoes.
Are there deer in Ireland?
Probably.
Well, or they're the king's deer.
Wildlife.
I'm fairly sure there's deer in England.
Oh, yep, red deer are in Ireland. Oh, there's a cute little badger!
You okay there, Chase?
I'm growling at the badger.
You do that?
Thank you. I will. Oh, okay. My back hurts.
Pony, why are you just... What are you carrying?
Pony, elk...
Why are you carrying raccoon meat?
Because they killed a raccoon. They weren't going to go after a deer, that's for fucking sure.
Screw that noise.
I still can't believe that's what happened.
Officially the best stream ever.
If only more people were here to witness your awfulness.
Actually, we have a pretty good stream going right now.
I mean, no
compared
one's...
to our usual standards.
I mean, no one's talking in chat because they're reclusive fucks, but it's going pretty well.
Well, they might just be thinking, what can we add to a 56 colonist being murdered by deer?
This guy fucking sucks, is one thing I'd say.
Well, maybe they're not assholes.
Hmm? Have you seen Twitch chats in bigger streams? The entirety of Twitch chat
streams,
are assholes.
So therefore, is more likely to have assholes.
Ah, that was loud.
A sign.
It's a sign.
Good news, we got our third bedroom done.
Is it for the deer?
No.
Oh, okay.
I mean, we all know the deer technically own this place now, so...
This is our land.
Pretty much.
This is my home, this is my land, I don't like no strangers. Feed the good, feed the kids good, beat the kids good, and tie them up. That is music and lyrics by Porcupine Tree. Before Stephen Wilson sues us for copyright infringement, I love you.
And if he does, thank you, Chase.
I totally didn't think to look if there are, like, berries or anything around.
If he does sue us, that means I'll have an autograph from Stephen Wilson, and I'll be entirely okay with that.
The entire purpose would just so you could get an autograph.
Except I would sell it. Because you would send it to me.
You would sell it to pay for the legal fees.
No, I wouldn't.
No, Corey would.
I would.
Oh.
Because he would send it to me.
I'd sell Corey before I let him sell that.
Dang it, the deers are eating all the berries.
Are you going to choose something about that, Nick?
Probably not. The deers are the master of this land. Forget the other tribes. The deer are the true overlords.
God fucking damn it.
So awkward silence.
I'm sorry, what's... what?
Oh gosh, a raid.
Raid. Wait, is the deer
Are the
raid?
Deer back?
I'm being raided by Flynn Rider.
That's a raider name if I ever heard one.
He's actually just Wasn't named Flynn a... and he's a commissar apparently. So I'm being raided by the communists.
Oh. Sounds kind of shitty.
Where are you going to prepare? Oh, you're coming from that direction. Of course you are. Okay, well, everybody, congratulations, you're drafted.
Remember the last time we got drafted? was in an alternate universe.
We died to deer. What are you armed with? Trobo. You can wield that. Equip wooden spear. Where is Elk? There you are, Elk.
Wait. The deer won against Elk?
That's not how it works. Have you seen an elk? They're like twice as large.
And they taste better.
Oh, so much better.
And yet my dad wants to shoot a deer.
Why?
Probably because he thinks it's easier.
Well, it definitely is. I can agree with him there.
Let's go bait him
into
attacking.
Yeah, but I'd rather try. I have to figure out that kind of thing for myself.
Have you tried a deer before? Or not a deer, an elk before?
Oh, you know, yeah, I was, but, like, the fall I was going to...
Oh, yeah. He kind of fell over.
You took attacking. A tumble.
That's all that happened, right?
Yeah, pretty much. While walking to class.
So you told me it was actually in class that you walked the door. Hi, everybody! Oh, God!
Okay, so we handled the raid.
You could handle a human raid.
To be fair, it was one dude.
Did he have a garbage can lid as a shield and a
no.
broom handle as a sword?
He didn't even have that, honestly.
You've equipped baseball bat!
Hey, you played Mother 2 as well.
I played what?
Mother 2, or Earthbound.
Yeah, I know what Mother 2 is. It's the one with Ness and Lucas.
Yeah. Well, Lucas was Mother 3.
Oh. Well, fuck you too, then.
Yes, the JRPG I really like.
You don't like any JRPGs.
You're right. I've just been saying so to... entertain you.
Oh boy, a camel hair.
I don't think that works well because there's literally only one that I've ever played.
So, I technically like JRPGs better than you?
Technically. Yeah.
What's with the technically? This isn't old news. But this isn't new news. This is old hat. Because you've actually, like, played Final Fantasy games.
He has a point.
I've only played a fucking demo.
But it was a really good demo. It
really was. I was surprised.
So yeah, we survived our first raid.
I thought you won that raid a while ago.
We did, I'm just restating the fact.
Oh, good job. You could handle a raid, but can you handle a deer?
I may just go have to purge the deer at some point.
Hey guys, did you know that the purge is actually a really cool concept?
No.
Order, mine. Yes, please.
Order 1866? Or 1886? That's how forgettable that game was. No one even remembers what the title's called.
Okay, I saw, like, one bit of footage that he was shooting machine gun.
No, pistol.
Wow, seriously, I don't... Yeah. I mean, it looked good from the screenshots I saw, but,
You're talking about 1886, or... You're talking about 1886 or this game?
That is a fair question.
1886.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was excited for it, but... Then everyone said it was shit, and I was like, oh.
Cool. What? Aren't my potatoes ready yet?
No.
Roughly 80%. Okay.
They take some great days to grow, but luckily, they have a chance of putting out two potatoes instead of just one.
Yes.
You know what I'm talking about.
And we have food, so that's good.
You have food, you have shelter, what more do you need? Just keep it like this and fast forward until the end game.
Well, I need to build a few more bedrooms. And research stuff and all kinds of other things.
I disagree. If you don't research, you don't get new technology and things don't get more difficult. You literally just kind of hang out in the cave, go out for food when you need to, and just keep doing that for thousands and thousands of years. Never let anything progress. So I can tell you're not on board with that idea.
Yeah, I'm not on board with that idea. Ooh, I have visitors. Oh, I had visitors, they left. Oh.
And Clarice! Uncle Owen! How good to see you! Wait, what kind of visitors were they?
Traitors.
Traitor!
I got a nice little colony going on here.
I guess.
Oh, that might be why the light's different. Technically, the bedrooms are underground, whereas the big area isn't.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Tra-la-la, everybody's napping.
Did you really just say tra-la-la?
Yep.
Are you Captain Underpants now?
No.
You guys read Captain Underpants,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Yes.
Tra-la-la.
Pony, stop trying to have social time with a sleeping person.
Ponies don't know proper etiquette. They're kind of like socially awkward penguin.
Uh-huh.
Is that still a meme?
I have no clue.
I'm going to go on a journey of self-discovery. I'm going to go on 9gag and see what memes are still alive. Confession Bear is still a fucking thing.
I'm going to try and tame a deer.
Have fun with that. So,
after Pony finishes cooking, because she's also my tamer.
Literally the fifth image on 9gag is fucking socially awkward penguin. They've been writing off that for 5 fucking years.
Could be worse. You could be looking at iPunny.
He has a point.
I mean, they're basically the same thing. Because people just post everything to both.
Chop that wood. Potatoes are not quite ready yet.
Potatoes, tomatoes, potatoes, potatoes. Frijoles!
Oh, hey, we found, like, a cave. Oh, we found an underground lake. Well, I suppose it's handy to have some water.
Great place to go fishing in.
Albeit it might be a little bit awkward for poor Blues, who's going to have his room literally have to go through water to get to it. But, you know, whatever. Architect, order structure, door. Furniture. Bed? No. Cancel. Bed. There, that looks better. I should probably also put lighting in.
Oh my god.
What?
Yeah, I'm going off 9gag. So, I'm going to go on a short rant that I actually hold close to my heart. So there's this video on 9gag that's like, this is the tallest and fastest roller coaster on the planet. Boom, boom, boom.
Uh-huh.
And it's showing this video of a roller coaster in a music park that I've been to.
Uh-huh.
So it's showing the roller coaster, like the FOV style roller coaster cam. But it shows a roller coaster that goes faster and is taller in the fucking video in the background. It's literally showing it, and it's like, it is 223 feet tall. I'm sitting there like, the tallest roller coaster in the world is 450 feet tall. And there's even one at the same amusement park that's 420 feet tall. What's this 223 feet tall bullshit?
Don't ask me.
The internet being
this
stupid?
Is literally just stupid, like, needless karma of just saying it's the tallest roller coaster on the planet when it's tiny. 223 feet is nothing anymore. What are the comments on this?
Wowee, that's tall.
The top thing.
I want to ride that roller coaster.
Elk Trobo Banastra, you have beds, so you need to have beds. Pony.
Yeah, I was gonna say, okay. This is flat out wrong. It's the tallest and fastest vertical drop coaster. Which is completely different than anything else, because no one makes vertical drop coasters. Because they're kind of fucking bullshit, because you can make much better things.
Uh-huh.
God, this website's dumb. I'm out. They can't even get the fucking roller coaster facts right. Read a book, motherfuckers.
Oh my gosh. We're harvesting potatoes.
Can you repeat that in an Irish accent? I didn't get... I didn't catch that.
Oh my gosh, we're harvesting potatoes.
Oh my god, you're so good.
This is actually super duper good, though. This means I have food to last for quite a while.
Calm down there, Mark Watney. Are you going to dip those potatoes in Vicodin?
I might have to. Just and Trobo is researching while wearing her caveman outfit. Oh, his caveman outfit. I apologize, Trobo. You
don't know how he identifies. Refer to him as it. Or sorry, they.
For anybody who's just joined us, I'm playing RimWorld.
No one. Well, Jackal's in now. Yes, hi, Jackal.
That's why I said.
For anyone, except the one guy we know.
Well, I don't know. Somebody else might have joined. You never know.
Tiger was in for a bit, but no, he's never spoken to us.
We were worried. It just wasn't
thank
the
God.
Same without you, Jackal.
I was literally, like, throwing up in suspense.
I need to build me a wall, because...
Whoa, there! Let's just calm the fuck down, Nick.
Technically speaking, his, never mind.
Okay.
Technically speaking, I'm not entirely sure that's a private room. Because there's a hole in the wall.
It's a glory hole. It is private, Nick.
But yay, everybody has bedrooms. Everybody can sleep happily. We have potatoes.
But do you have a herd of deer that's going to murder everyone?
I told you,
yes.
I'm trying to tame a deer.
You're trying to make
Jackal,
peace with them now.
You missed that... out. This colony was technically killed off by a herd of marauding deer.
Literally, a herd of deer just came in and killed everyone. It was the greatest thing ever. And also, yes, that's also my favorite. That's my national pastime.
So, you befriended one? Are you going to sign a peace treaty and send him back to his home where he'll be good of the human civilization?
Sounds like a plan.
Stan.
A new area has been revealed. Jump to location. Oh, yeah, the hole I mined. Okay. How's that research on electricity coming? 127 points. Alrighty. Toggle the beauty display. Oh, okay, it tells how ugly or non-ugly the built area is. Reportedly, there was an area like over here that was super duper. Oh well, that's super duper ugly. Is there anywhere that's like particularly beautiful? Apparently, like right here.
The place that's most beautiful is wherever you are.
Thank you. What other displays do we got? Room stats. Impressiveness 5. Dull. Wealth 102, impoverished, spaced rather tight, beauty ugly, but it's
spaced
clean.
Rather tight. Like, in the slang of, yo dog, that's tight. There's some helpful tips in the chat for you, by the way.
I agree, but these people don't understand that. Like I said, these people were killed off by a herd of marauding deer. They aren't going to understand how to do Ben Franklin's experiment with lightning. What animals do I have? Oh my gosh! Did I actually recruit a deer?
What?
Yeah, there was a deer walking around the base.
Yes, I recruited a deer!
That thing's going to murder you!
Buck of Green
Slade. Get it out of there!
Age 9. What can I train it to do? Obedience.
Yeah, you should probably train it to be obedient before it betrays you.
Cats can't be trained, by the way, fun fact.
What did you say?
I can't train the cat.
That makes sense, actually.
Have you ever tried training a cat?
Yeah, it's a cat. What did you expect? They poop in boxes and that's literally all they know.
So this is going definitely better than the last one. Instead of being murdered by a deer, I have a pet deer now.
So to go slightly off topic, so I think you might really like this prog rock album that I named the stream after. It's literally just, it sounds like... What?
Side note before you go on your rant, I found an ostrich.
Tame the ostrich and ride it like an Australian. It's basically Australia. I just realized that. But no, so this album that I'm listening to, I just have it on the background. It's literally just like ambient music to a sci-fi game. That's literally what it sounds like, except Phil Collins sometimes comes in and starts drumming.
I kind of want this.
I will send you the link so you can listen to it later. That's literally what it is. Just have it on as background music for playing something. And it has Phil Collins in it for some fucking reason. What's not to love?
So now I'm
going to
try and
singing.
So now I'm going to try and tame a doe so I can actually make more deer.
Doe, a deer, a female deer, and sleep. What about sleep? I mean, we need sleep. Trust me. I'm fucking tired, but... I think Tiger's telling you that you should probably go the fuck to bed, Nick.
Never.
Talking about in the game.
Oh, in game?
No, in real life.
Oh, I'm so confused.
Your mother actually has a Twitch account and is now telling us that you need to. You should probably go to bed before it gets too late.
Is it bad that I kind of wouldn't be surprised?
He doesn't listen to me when I barge into his room while he's playing his video games. Maybe if I message him.
Well, doesn't that happen on the NLSS? Doesn't the one guy's dad just get on Twitch?
Yeah, I think that happens. Oh, he's referring to the cat, not you. Okay.
Oh, cats. Okay.
But seriously, though, you should go to sleep, too.
I'm good. Tonight's my I get to stay up as late as I want night because I don't have class.
That's every night for me.
Until your mom just wakes up at 4 in the morning and asks you why the hell you're still awake.
That was so fucking funny. I so wish we were streaming at that point.
Why is there an ostrich marauding through my potatoes?
Is this the infamous battle between Australia and Ireland?
Oh good. Banastra killed another raccoon. They need to be purged.
So you're purging raccoons because you can win against them, but the deer can live because they kicked your ass.
I'm taming the deer so I can have deer herds.
Tame the raccoon and put jetpacks on it. Then have Bradley Cooper voice it.
I'm also smoothing out the floor so my people will stop groaning about their house being ugly. Also, apparently...
They live in a cave. They realize they live in a cave, right?
People are literally complaining about having dirty floors.
Well, just ugly caves in general. Okay, they like nice caves. I do enjoy seeing a deer wandering around the base now.
What the fuck do these people want? Fucking Lasko?
Yay, the cat's healed.
That took
healed.
Years to make. They don't deserve that. They've done nothing.
I feel like I should plant another
caveman.
Field.
Yeah, you probably should.
Hey, only Willie Nelson can tell people to get an education.
This is true.
We need to go on another shopping trip, too.
Yes,
we keep
do.
Referencing that one shopping trip and that one camping trip.
I mean, I offered to do stuff with you guys this summer, but you're like, "Yeah, let's wait and see what happens, and then I'll be out of the country, so
that's
fuck off."
That's not true. Not when it comes to shopping at Hastings, you git. What should I grow? I should grow...
pot.
I can grow hops, but I don't have anyone with good enough farming.
Oh.
Let's grow corn.
Corn's always good.
Corn.
Get some variety.
Okay, I don't think we can really talk about farming in this without turning this into a Stardew Valley stream, because I was about to mention it.
Yeah, that's kind of hard. Sorry, Nick.
Whatever.
Maybe we should just dedicate this channel to just Persona and Stardew Valley. Nothing else. And CK2.
Yeah, I was about to say, I feel like I would have no point on this channel anymore.
Maybe if you played one of them.
So, Stardew, we're telling him to play Stardew Valley?
I guess. That's probably the one that he wouldn't just be like, this is fucking bullshit, too.
Well, it's the one he would give a good college try to.
Yes.
Plus, you know, who knows when he's gonna actually be able to go on and get a PS2.
He's been talking about it for a couple months now.
Yeah, I'm planning on doing it. I might actually be able to now that I have money. Although Harry Potter's a higher priority.
Isn't Harry Potter free?
Not if the library... Look, the copy of the library has been due since the 17th.
Nick, I could probably borrow the... Because my sister has... Oh god, I'm so sorry.
She's Rick. Control yourself, Rick.
Morty! Nick! My sister, she has Harry Potter movies. No, my sister has all the Harry Potter movies on DVD, not Blu-ray. So I could probably borrow them and then loan them all to you.
That sounds like a lovely thing. Please do. I'm tired of waiting for the library to get their crap together.
Only on one condition, though.
What?
You invite me when you get your PS2.
I mean, yeah, I'm not against that idea.
So I want to go back to that place.
Oh, I can build graves.
Fucking what?
I can build marriage spots. I can build a party spot.
Ooh, build a party spot.
Let's build a marriage spot first, see if anything happens.
Apparently imitating Rick Sanchez is the new Rick Rolled. I completely approve of this.
Don't you miss being Rick Rolled?
Hmm?
Or did you get, like, way too smart and realize that, oh yeah, this thing's way too good to be exist? It probably is.
What are you talking about?
You know, when, like, Rick Rolling was a thing?
It's still a thing. I mean,
really? I thought, like, everyone was wise at this point. So there's absolutely no point in doing it.
Well, the thing is, for me, I like that song.
Well, like, it doesn't count if you do it to yourself.
No, the last day of my senior year of high school, I Rickrolled the entire school. Me and a friend were just walking by the office and while they were doing the morning announcements, and this was, like, literally the last day for us of high school. So we ran in, and I, put my phone speakers right up to the intercom and just started blaring Never Gonna Give You Up.
There's an ostrich sleeping in my potato patch
that
now.
That sounds better than our last day of high school. By the way, Nick, what did happen on our last day?
Are we talking graduation day or just last official day of classes?
Last official day.
Last official day?
Nothing happens
All
on
All I remember
day.
Is having a cooking class with Mary and Mary. Yes, I had that cooking class with both Marys. It was confusing. Oh, and also, for the people in chat, the reason I'm talking about Harry Potter is I've only seen the first one and the one where Dumbledore dies.
Spoilers, first of all. And yeah, you should get caught up.
What beeped?
I know the reason now why you're not getting caught up is because of the library, but...
So there's a solar flare shutting down all electrical devices. Too bad I have literally no electricity, so I don't care.
Oh no, your torches might blow out.
Turns out the deer are all electronic and they just all fall over.
That'd be hilarious. Just episode 1 style, they all just shut off.
I've been trying, Jackal. I have legitimately been trying.
I do leave the house. I drove 70 miles today.
That's my way home.
No, not...
Plus, this is like a once in a, what, 2 months deal?
It varies, just depending on when he needs me to come over. Oh, it's another wolf.
That's a good question. How did you kill that wolf in the beginning?
I don't know.
Yet deer were a little bit too difficult for you.
I'm very confused right now. Have I managed to recruit the doe yet? I haven't recruited the doe yet.
So, Jackal, just for context, though, he had to go 2 miles further than where I literally live.
You
I don't live anymore.
Yeah, you visit there on a regular basis. You don't live there.
I live there at times when my dad decides to piss off out of the country and is like, yo, you take care of everything. So I'm like, cool, let me drive 50 miles to get to the college and then drive 50 miles back. By the way, Nick, you drove 100 miles today. It's 54 miles from here to...
Well, I probably drove a little bit more than 100 because I did spend 20 minutes lost in Livingston.
It's not the... Oh, my God. You get lost in my hometown of 4,000 people. That's adorable.
To be fair, again, that was the second time I've literally ever... I didn't do too terrible of a job. I was only, like, one road off of where I needed to be, and that was just
where'd
like...
Where'd you go?
Well, I was trying to get back onto Park, but I, like, went one road far too far over to the road that I needed to get onto Park and just kind of... Hold on. I hear combat happening. What was that noise?
Anyways, how long has the stream been going at this point?
Quite a while, but I'm having fun, for 2 hours. I really don't care. And we have people watching, so whatever. I'm fine with going for a while more. I'm having fun. Okay, so it was just a fox killing a rat, so...
You go, fox.
We have yet to tame the female deer, so...
Red Apoca Golden Sun.
What to build next? A workshop house. Would sound like a good idea.
I know, these guys are really adamant about, cleaning up the cave.
They're working at it.
I just realized my stream's been frozen for like 10 minutes. Let me refresh that. Oh, hey, it looks different now. Oh, no, it's an advertisement for Jason Bourne.
There are worse things to advertise?
Guy Fieri was trying to sell me Miller Lite the other day.
That must have been a confusing experience.
It was terrifying. It's Guy Fieri. It's Miller Lite. You know me well enough to know that I don't drink bitch beers.
I have had a sip of Miller Lite.
Unless it's Mangoritas, because those things put me to sleep and it's lovely.
That can be another storeroom, and we need to make like a mess hall.
They're cavemen.
Yeah, but even cavemen need to have a nice room to eat in and party.
Also, can we welcome back Robot Corey?
Welcome Robot Corey to the land of the humans. I know we are strange and you want to terminate
destroy
us,
all humans?
But don't. I'm John Connor, you're here to protect me. This is a really weird Terminator reboot.
Woo! Kill all humans! Bite my shiny metal ass.
Hello, Bender.
Alright. Corey is sleepy.
How many fucking quotes did I have to do before you realize that?
Corey, go to sleep.
To be fair, I couldn't understand a third of what you were saying, Corey. What's beeping? Ah, raid! Ah, it's a dude with a club! We got this. Stick the deer on him.
Okay, do I need to just go back to chat?
Nope, you're back.
Congratulations, everybody, you're drafted.
But I didn't fill out my draft papers.
Including the Yorkshire Terrier, because apparently Pony managed to tame the Yorkshire Terrier to the point that the Yorkshire Terrier will fight with us. We're going to stick a Yorkie on him. Oh, we apparently already handled it while I wasn't even looking. Cool, well, undraft. Unforbid.
So, Nick.
Sup?
My sister is totally down to let me borrow her Harry Potter movies, but you will have to watch them in a slightly leisurely pace, well, not leisurely, quicker pace just so I can get them back to her in a timely manner. I'm not saying watch all of them in one day.
Quicker pace than, you know, when he borrowed
Assassin's
when
Creed?
When he borrowed the first one from me.
Oh.
I love how I have seen that, though. I saw that one before I saw Harry Potter.
The first time you saw that, though, was in the last year, though.
Again, I had a very sheltered childhood.
I just love how you're, like, one of your favorite composers is John Williams, yet you've seen, like, barely any of his movies that he did the soundtrack to. Well, that's because, name other ones, then.
Let's see. We got Jaws,
Star Wars,
Jurassic Park. What was the one I watched very recently?
Harry Potter,
yeah. I've seen several others off the top of my head. I can't remember, but I know I've seen more than that. What is happening?
Have either of you seen
Cheddar,
War of the Worlds?
What are you doing?
The War of the Worlds remake.
No, but I know of it.
With
so,
Tom Cruise.
My cat killed a bunny.
Good for him. He's doing his barnyard cat duties.
There's a fox. Hunt the fox. Tally-ho! Mainly because he's kind of in my base, and that's bad.
I did not realize how many movies...
Yeah, John Williams has done a lot of movies.
Scores for... Yep!
I'm still here. Go, Yorkie! Attack the fox! Where is Elk? Or is Elk my hunter? Where's Banastra? That red fox was being very mean to my poor little Yorkshire Terrier. It needs to die. Holy crap. Who's my melee attacker? Trobo! You know what? Just draft you then. Fine. Okay, crisis averted. Colony was not killed off by a single fox. We're good. Corey, are you still here? Corey? Oh, you're in chat. Okay. So we're having fox meat tonight.
Lovely.
Welcome back, Chase.
Hey, Jackal's seen War of the Worlds. Unlike you, plebs.
So my buddy.
Goodbye, Chase.
Who, what now?
Welcome back, Chase.
I'm back again. Have you seen E.T.?
Yes. Oh. That was a John Williams track, wasn't it? Soundtrack.
Yes. Schindler's List.
Yes. Good movie. Who has a poor movie? Elk. What?
I wouldn't say it's a...
What?
Good... I don't know.
Why are you hungry? We have, like, ridiculous amounts of potatoes.
Did not know that John Williams did the soundtrack or score for Saving Private Ryan.
Yes.
And The Adventures of Tintin.
Hold on, Bills. Can I change this to...
No.
15. Yes. Nope, John Williams is just awesome.
He's alright.
Okay, cool. So my people are all healed up from their intense battle with the fox.
Was it Star Fox?
It might have been. It was a pretty mean fox. So what I'm building over here right now is the storeroom and either a workshop or a mess hall. I haven't decided yet. What is this? Camel hair t-shirt. What are you wearing?
What?
Cloth tribal wear.
Good thing he's not wearing a camel toe t-shirt.
Trobo, you know what? Oh, it's shoddy. Well.
I see how it is.
Oh yeah, there was a dead body I should have looted. Where was that? Oh, did we already handle it? We already handled it. We're chill. I should probably make a grave for that that guy.
Who died while I was gone?
A raider.
Oh.
Just because it's kind of awkward just to have a rotting human corpse just laying over there in the corner. Where should I put the grave? Eh, we don't need a grave. He can just rot over in the corner. I changed my mind. Sometimes you just need to leave the dead to rot. But no, we're coming along quite nicely here. Blue, what are you doing? Watching the sunset. Daw. What else should I grow? How's that research coming? 162%?
Should be done.
No. Out of 3600.
Either of you have experience with discogs.com?
No, not off the top of my head. I mean, I recognize the name, but I don't remember why I recognize the name.
It kind of seems like a... What's that board game site that you sometimes use for, like, seeing prices of board games?
Board Game Geek.
Yes, that one. It's kind of like that, but for music.
Uh-huh.
I'm just not sure if it's a trusted thing yet.
Pony, have you... Why have you not managed to... tame that deer yet? You're failing me. You disappoint me. Where's Haskell? Haskell.
Rascal. Haskell!
Obedience and release. Oh, Indiana Jones. Yeah, that was a thing.
Yeah.
Forgot about that for some reason.
Pretty much anything epic is John Williams. Which is... I don't know. Any more John Williams, I hate to say this, is kind of like the top 40 for me. Is that like... Well, of like more classical-oriented stuff.
Uh-huh.
It's like, yeah, John Williams. Totally haven't heard any of his stuff 10,000 times before. Still love him, of course, but...
Uh-huh.
Is like, oh, I know, I love classical music. Da 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 da.
So I know I need.
That's it. Also that's just me being a pretentious asshole, though. I have accepted that.
I need to just have another place just to dump rocks. Now.
Have you tried a quarry?
Yes, I'm actually about to try that.
When am I not? That is a good question, Corey. Also, fuck you. Also, you're right.
Cool, well that's a good new place to dump crap.
I
Everybody's sleeping. We're chill.
Okay, Corey, to remark your just hatred of hatefulness. I'm mostly joking when I'm a pretentious ass. Sometimes.
Mostly.
I'm mostly joking, but deep down, I am 100% serious and like, fuck you all. Hey, I love hate.
I'm gonna make an orchard.
Isn't it gonna be an angry orchard?
I'll save that for when I'm making hops.
Not hatred, that game can fuck right off. I mean, it wasn't awful, it was just... they just used controversy to sell their game, and I don't agree with that. I mean, the game was just mundane. Talking about hatred, by the way.
Let's just grow some pine trees, because why not? Oh, because we're in a temperate forest. Let's grow some birch trees. Corey, I'm going to make a birch forest.
Is everything just of doom in this game?
That's a specific reference to the Minecraft server.
Oh.
And it's endless, endless birch tree forests.
Yeah, I remember this story. I'm just saying, because, like, Jackal said the deer of doom. I probably said the raccoon of doom, because that sounds cool. Now Corey's saying the birch forest of doom. This basically sums up this game. Pretty soon it's going to be the storeroom of doom.
What beeped? Oh, one of my Yorkshire Terriers is pregnant.
Beep.
We're going to have more Yorkies.
Doom 5, Rimworld. I want my laptop back so I can play Doom that's not at 20 FPS. Or 15 or 10 or however well.
Wait, what?
Done. What?
What enemy hasn't been incapacitated? There's apparently an enemy I incapacitated, but I don't know where or what or how.
Isn't that a good thing, though?
Except I can capture them, supposedly.
Oh.
Except I don't know where they are. Animals, no statistics. Research. They're down here. No. Crap! Blight killed my crops. Well, that's a problem. No, but I like this game. It's official. I don't know where they've been incasted, so I don't care. Unless they're that dude. Nope, he's dead. Look at that lovely little birch forest. We should probably replant the potatoes, because that's going to kind of screw us over otherwise.
You lost all your potatoes?
A bunch of them, a blight hit.
Ooh.
Yeah,
that'd do it.
That one. Build me... ooh, I can build shivs. Fun.
Show me shivs. Ding. No? Okay. This isn't a game of Family Feud?
No.
Shh. Oh.
Yes.
Ow.
Ow.
We're good.
Okay.
Just don't worry about it. So I'm on the Doom 6 Family Feud.
We're playing the feud.
Show me Demon Spawn. Ding, yay.
Let's mine those two blocks of limestone. I don't like them. I really need to tame that female deer already.
You just need to sing the song.
But copyright infringement.
Isn't it out of the... Isn't it archived by this point?
I don't know.
I'll just do different...
Corey, fucking... you should Google these things.
No, I'll just sing in a different style.
Don't a deer, a female deer.
It's a cougar.
Ray, a pocket going fly.
Me, a name that I call myself.
Oh, a deer destruction man!
How's that?
Okay. I guess.
I was trying to throw in a little bit of magma near the end there, but it didn't really work because I'm not insane.
Open full graves or containers. I'm good. I don't want to dig any graves up. For some reason. How's my research coming along? Incredibly slowly. You know what? I'm gonna change it to stone cutting. Yay! The storeroom area is done.
The storeroom area? Or storeroom?
Storeroom.
Oh. So when are you gonna start building that ship to get home?
Probably once I get out of the Stone Age.
When does that happen?
Well, normally you would have the tech. You'd be a lot farther along technologically, so you'd be able to actually build some of the ship parts. But seeing as I don't even understand electricity right now,
have you tried the kite and key thing? I think it's a pretty good idea.
Haul all that crap out in the morning. Just because it's not needed. Ah! Raid and a heat wave! Crap, I have to make sure my people don't get heat stroke. Oh gosh, these people actually look kind of scary. One of them has a gun. Congratulations, everyone, you're drafted. Where to hide.
Why are you so obsessed with drafting?
Just am, okay? You don't understand. Hoo-ah! Look at my lovely little squad of cavemen.
Hoo-ah.
And one dude with a gun.
Cavemen and gun. Where'd the gun come from?
That was the guy who showed up late. Or showed up after the start of the game.
Oh. How'd you kill a guy with a gun, yet you couldn't kill a deer?
Because the gun is what triggered the deer into their insane charge of doom and death.
This is... Yeah. Yeah. Because deer are the true demons.
Yep.
I don't remember killing any deer in Doom, though. Your move, Corey. Doom 8, deer. How many... Wait, you forgot Doom 7!
You have a point. Come on, come at me. Are you guys just leaving? Okay, no. Come on, Bash.
There you go.
Bash, Keef, and Tally. Is that what your name is? No, it's Tail. Never mind, you need to die. Why? Because you're out in the rain and you had to get up out of bed. Yes, actually.
I'm pretty sure the movie's called Love, Actually. I wouldn't know, though, because I haven't seen it. Apparently it's okay.
Autosave. Perfect time to autosave right there. Release the animals. Release the Yorkshire hounds.
Release the hounds! What's that from? Besides, well, history.
I'm not entirely sure off the top of my head.
What about the bottom?
Hey, one down.
Hey.
Who said you could... Is that deer chasing me?
Again?
Nope. Okay. Maybe. Yes.
Yeah, Corey, Release the River is from Evan Almighty, Where the Dam Breaks.
I feel like...
As he facepalms so hard.
I feel like that's not where that's from. Just saying.
I disagree.
Cool, well, it looks like we survived. Why is there a mad... What? Why is there a local buffalo going mad? Guys, guys, there's a buffalo coming.
You want to repeat that one?
Guys, please? Guys, there's a buffalo coming.
Yeah, it is.
That's kind of actually scary. Oh, gosh.
So that's how you feel.
Okay. It's breaking the door down. Congratulations, hey. You're redrafted.
Hey, everyone. Nick is scared of coming muff. Allos. Why'd they name it Buffalo? That's such an oversight.
I don't know.
They need to patch that.
I like it. It's funny.
Especially when the lines, "There's a buffalo coming," comes up.
Okay, so the deer killed the buffalo. I'm not joking. That's marvelous. I just realized I don't have enough beds for all the animals. I'm a monster. Furniture, animal sleeping spot. There, now I have enough beds for all the animals. Work. Set this guy to doctor because he's the only one of us who isn't wounded.
Is he going to be a good doctor?
So the buffalo isn't dead. The buffalo is in shock. Pony, before you...
Corey, it's actually Muffalo of Doom. Also, I think we're giving Bethesda way too many good ideas. Like, we should probably patent these and then sell them to them.
Yeah, probably.
Did you kill the buffalo?
No. It's in shock, so I'm gonna try and tame it.
Oh. Good luck with that.
Is it still a mad? No, it's just wandering now. Okay, we're cool. It's not violently trying to murder everyone now.
Yet.
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 Well, it's not killing the cat.
Yes. Yes. Doom charity. Yes. 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 Doom charity. Goose. Goo. Goo. Goo.
So yeah, now there's just a muffalo chilling out in my base.
There's a muffalo and a cat.
Yeah.
Cool. Not gonna make any.
Behave yourself.
Yeah, I'm refraining.
You better.
So hard.
Okay, so yeah, the muffalo's cool now. It's not gonna try and murder anyone.
I'm glad you've realized what your path is.
Who was my doctor?
The muffalo.
Dr. Muffalo.
MD.
So I'm having trouble remembering a word. Could you help me out?
Is it muffalo, perchance?
No. It's like where you have a something. How do I explain it? So you have a word that's really dirty, but then you have a different word that means the same thing, but it's much less dirty.
Uh-huh.
I forget what that's called.
An insinuate? No.
No, it's
an innuendo.
Innuendo, yes.
I don't think muffalo is an innuendo. I think it's pretty blatant what it is.
Shit, no, it's not innuendo, though. It's not colloquialism. It's something else.
Why can't I remember it? I dig this soundtrack.
Why can't I remember? Senior, what's it called? Please tell me, cause I'm freaking out now. Does it start with a D? No, but seriously.
I feel like you need to go to Urban Dictionary with this question.
No, it's an actual word that I learned in like English class. It's a common word. It's just I'm completely blanking right now.
I'm genuinely not sure what it is either.
It's not innuendo. What is it? Fuck. Don't you hate it when this happens?
What is it? What is it, Jackal?
Yeah, I've asked him. He's not telling me. He's a jerk. He's holding back.
Jackal, tell us. Be good. Don't make me sick the muffalo on you.
Euphemism! I think.
Possibly. I think. So, problems.
Yeah, euphemism! How could I not remember This stream has become a journey of self-discovery.
People have infections.
So what I was gonna say before, is that your cave is literally just walking euphemisms for vaginas. Muffalo. Pussy. Yeah, get a cookie. Aw. Corey also gave me a Dorito. Thanks, Corey.
Jesus, it's 105 degrees outside. Not here. I mean, it felt like it here, but I mean...
No, I was going to say, that doesn't sound too far off for today.
Well, people have infections, so that's not good.
Is that a microbacterium?
Probably.
That sucks, then. I should probably be put on IV antibiotics and an 18-month regimen of pills. So who's the doctor again? Elk?
Pony.
Elk and Pony are just carrying this team.
Also, there's blood everywhere in the base because the muffalo was bleeding.
Oh my god.
Yes, I know.
Was it its time of the month? You're right, Nick. Don't change the name of Buffalo.
Elk went berserk.
Elk went berserk. What? What is happening? Nick, tell me. Elk's going berserk. Buffalo's bleeding everywhere. Oh, God. We need to hire someone just to do, like, supercuts of these streams of the actual funny bits.
Uh-huh.
That are just us being idiots. Corey, download all our VODs and do supercuts of everything.
Yeah, Corey.
Yeah, Corey. He already said no.
Too bad.
I mean, somewhere I did write down all the funny moments of our Euro Truck stream.
So, we're just gonna hope Elk chills out and kind of avoid her.
There's a deer in the...
I know.
Oh, okay.
That's the one I tamed.
Wait, Elk's a girl?
Elk's the... Yes, right there, that one.
Oh. Okay.
She's attacking the... She killed the muffalo!
What a bitch!
That muffalo wasn't hurting anybody.
I think you need to kill Elk.
I'm gonna see if she calms down.
Sacrifice her, Nick.
Well, at least we can get some meat from the buffalo.
Sacrifice her to...
Who is that?
The sacred god...
Hey, Elk, stop snapping. We're good. So yeah, if people's mental states get too low, this is what happens. They just kinda snap.
They kill your buffalo.
Yes, they do.
I mean, I could have said sacrifice it to you thought I was going to say.
I mean, you could have.
See, I'm doing good at refraining today.
What did I do? Corey, that was Chase's idea. Not mine.
I'm just letting it happen. Anyone else hear that massively loud train?
No.
Okay, cool. I just didn't know if it was getting picked up on my microphone. I swear, there cops like go by my house like 2 times a day, like with their sirens on. I'm kind of concerned, but I guess it's a normal thing. Like, maybe they just do daily parades of just one cop car?
Maybe.
I mean, it's not unheard of. I know fucking... What's that place? Vancouver. They shoot off a cannon every night at 9 for the sheer fucking hell of it.
That's
I was walking around there one day, and I was just sitting there. We were just walking, and I heard this huge blast because we were near the cannon that they use. And I thought it was a terrorist attack because it was just like... Poof! I'm like... Fuck! Then this Canadian guy walks past me, he's like, oh, that's just our daily cannon. I'm like, fucking what? Oh, you don't know, in Vancouver we shoot off a cannon every night, eh? Why? It's tradition, eh? Oh, okay. I'm sorry it scared you. Thanks, Canadian guy.
At least he apologized.
He didn't actually sound Canadian. He didn't apologize either.
I feel like this entire sequence...
Hmm?
What? Elk went berserk again.
Kill Elk.
Elk attacked Cheddar. Elk dies.
Oh. Well, that's good. Let me know. Give me an update. Elk is such a dick.
Yes, she is.
Wait, which one's Cheddar?
the cat. Who else isn't dead?
She's killing my euphemisms, Nick. Stop her.
Working on it.
Can you buy me this game, Nick?
Cheddar might actually kill elk. Oh gosh, the deer. Oh, I thought the deer was going to attack elk. That would have been. Oh, the git killed Cheddar. Nope, he's just in shock. Okay. Is elk dead? No. He's just captured.
Kill her. She doesn't deserve to live. Rimworld Civil War. Oh, fuck off.
Of course, the first video you find is Marvel related.
Huh?
Oh, I thought you said. Oh, that was Corey.
That's what Corey said.
Oh. I'm just gonna keep Blue here with his gun, in case Elk decides to flip out again.
Is Elk in a cage?
Elk is in a medical bed.
You should probably put her in a cage.
I don't have the time or the resources to build a cage right now.
Oh, so you're just gonna let her wake up and murder more?
No, if she wakes up and gets out of bed, there's a dude with a gun literally 2 feet away from her.
Just use the gun right now.
I'm good.
You know what must be done, Nick.
Oh, I can do that. That's interesting.
Is it caged?
Hold on. I might have a solution.
No. Nicholas, cage.
Good job. That was a really hard one for you, I bet.
That took all of my thought processes.
I bet. Somebody go build that wall. Okay, well, Elk doesn't have her spear anymore, so at least there's that. It's all gone wrong. Somebody's in a daze now. Trobo! Of course, the person who's treating Elk has gone insane now.
What is happening?
It's all gone wrong.
Corey says he gives that joke a B!
Okay, pony then. Banastra? Of course, the one who's the constructor.
Did the constructor go crazy too?
Yes, the constructor is the one who officially. When. You're. Blue. No, not Blue. Pony.
Pony's dead. You're next. So if this teaches us anything, is that this game can go tits up real fucking fast.
Yeah. Who has severe illness? Elk. Why is Elk up and about? She's not psychotic right now. Okay. Never mind. She's psychotic. Blue, come here. Get your gun.
Blue, get your gun. We're going elk hunting. So since things
She's
are...
fighting the cat again.
Why? I mean, I understand dog people have their opinions, but still... So how's Felix doing, Nick?
Fine.
Cool. But what about Rascal?
Pretty good.
What about Haskell?
Hold on. Okay. Elk is down again.
Oh my god.
Ugh. Rascal!
Rascal!
Rescue her and then arrest her.
Or just arrest her and not rescue her. You're part of the problem, Nick. Of, oh, we can change these complete psychopaths.
It's not even really that. It's just a matter of
She's gone berserk 3 times and murdered a cat! I have a kid that does that in my neighborhood and we call him Psycho. That's only partly a joke. The kid kind of scares me.
Elk got up out of bed again and immediately passed out, so I'm okay with that.
Oh my god. You just need to kill her, Nick.
I physically...
I will pay you $1 American.
One.
Or if you give me 3 weeks, I'll pay you $1 Canadian, which is about 70 cents.
Okay, so Banaster just went berserk for literally no reason, so seeing as it's 11 o'clock, I feel like this is a good time to call the stream.
Just let them all murder each other while we discuss. What do you think about the game?
I like it a lot.
Anything else?
I'm thoroughly enjoying it. It's as proven by the fact that I got to watch a colony get destroyed by a horde of marauding deer, which was incredible.
Would you recommend it to a friend? A peer?
Are you asking for a friend?
I'm asking for a friend.
Probably.
Corey really wants it, I think.
Probably, yeah.
Would you recommend it to a mother or father or...
I don't know.
Uncle.
No, Tona died. Elk is dead.
How did Elk die? She was the one killing everyone.
Because we kind of just left her on the floor to die.
Oh.
Trobo is passed out. Pony is in medical bed. Blue is just taking a nap.
Well, good for him.
Banastra's passed out on the floor.
How can he sleep through all this?
Because I told him to just go to bed.
That's what I do. Just everyone's murdering each other around me. I'm just like, fuck it.
Also, the cat is just laying on the floor dying.
What about the deer?
The deer is surprisingly okay.
Deer are just fucking...
So are both the Yorkshire Terriers.
Yeah, I think this is a good time to just have an epic zoom in on Elk, the cause of all our problems.
Hold on. Can I... Blue.
You
can't. Blue is incapacitated. Okay. Is there anyone alive enough to actually get up? Pony? Nope, they're all officially incapacitated. It's officially game over.
Oh.
They're all incapacitated or dead.
And on that bombshell... If you want something that'll make you pull your hair out because no one knows what the fuck's happening yet, RimWorld. On
Hold
Steam
on.
Now. $29.99.
I got another dude.
No.
Yes, I got another dude. I have one thing I'm going to do with him.
Have him shoot himself?
Go eat elk.
Okay. He's a long ass ways away, though.
No, he's already in base.
Oh.
Also, there's a raid following him. So just eat that body and we're calling it a day. Cool, you munched on elk, we're good now.
This game. This fucking game.
I like it.
I might pick it up once it gets further to, or closer to completion. It's on my wish list, though, so. I'll keep an eye on it. Alright. Are we calling it?
Yeah.
Alright. Thanks for watching. This was RimWorld.
Yep. See y'all. It was fun. Night.